What up? It's your boy T-Bear here. Reaction. Today's Music Money. About to get into some DJ Premier. Salute to Floppy Disk. What's up? This is Double 36. And we're hitting Gangstar with Work and Anything, though. So, you know, we are definitely, I think we're winding down. I would originally, like I said, I originally would have had four more, but already did one early as well, too, which was another Gangstar one, just because I wanted to get ahead, just in case I didn't get a chance to do it, though, just a precaution. So after this, we're skipping 37, we have 38, 39, we have three more left, and then that'll be all for the, so what's up, unless you do another, till you do a new season, possibly, but either way, Work, definitely, I think it's from, if it's part of Moment of Truth, or exclusive to the Full Clip album. Let me double check. He'll break it down, but let me double check though. Gangstar. Yeah, I'm trying to remember if it's it's from Moment of Truth, was also on the Caught Up soundtrack as well too. So yeah. So anyway, other than that, let's take to see DJ Premier's story on how he made this little illustrious track, and it's a dope beat as well too. And let's check out the album cover. He got Sarita. I'm guessing that's Sarita, right? Who's yep? Because it's Stevie Wonder Presents. Because this is his Stevie Wonder's former wife, whose wife at the time and everything. So anyway, so let's check out DJ Premier explaining his work on Work. Let's get it.
I'm DJ Premier, and I present to you, So What's Up.
Okay, computer. Run it back.
So What's Up. 1997, some recording was going on to create a soundtrack to a movie that was released in February of 1998 called Caught Up, starring Bokeem Woodbine and Cinda Williams. Matter of fact, my first introduction to Cinda Williams is when she made her debut in the movie
Mo' Better Blues. Yep, because they did a song, a jazz thing for that soundtrack, yep.
Which prompted a Gangstar major release in that soundtrack, which starred Denzel Washington, Wesley Snipes, and of course, directed by Spike Lee. When Cinda made her debut, and we made our debut into the major label world, which was actually on Columbia Records at the time. Fast forward, which I always do from time to time, and we're actually gonna go back a little bit, but fast forward, as I said before, that puts us back to Caught Up. The soundtrack, which was on New Tribe Records slash Virgin Records, that was also our debut with our album Moment of Truth, which came out in March of 1998, because we had moved from Chrysalis Records to EMI Records to New Tribe Virgin. It was all the same distribution through our whole career, but it was just like what we call a transfer. So now we're with the big boys, Scarface, and the Rap-A-Lot Records family was there. Also, the Loonies was there. Janet Jackson was there. Even Mariah Carey had a short visit there. But Virgin was popping and doing their thing. Now, when the soundtrack was being assembled, Snoop Dogg and Corrupt were on there, the Loonies, the Lost Boys did a song, KRS-One, Mad Lion, and Shaggy did a record, and of course they asked Gangstar to create a song for the movie. Guru and I have always done a lot of records that have been on soundtracks, from White Man Can't Jump to Mo' Better Blues to 8 Mile with Eminem to Caught Up. Now, being that we were almost finishing our album during the same time, we said we'll take a pause to make a record for the soundtrack, and that song became
Work.
Work. So, this was not made for Moment of Truth. It was made for Caught Up. Just in case you are late to the table, and I say it on every episode, the sounds that you hear from all my previous recordings of my 90s career predominantly are saved on these floppy discs. These thin little floppy discs, thinner than a waffle, you know what I'm saying? And they are converted into data that is put into a machine that we preferably were using at the time, called the Akai S950 sampler. But we triggered the sounds with another device called the MPC-60, also made by Akai, and we plug them in through a cable called MIDI, where they can read each other and play at the same time when you sync it to a box that we preferably were using in our era called the Roland SBX80. And when you put all that together and run it into a 2-inch tape machine, no digital, then the product comes out all through this little thing right here. That era is pretty much gone now, but classics can never be denied or stricken away from the stone that it's been etched in. And these are etched in stone. So this record is really unique for several reasons. One, like I said, Cinda Williams starred in this movie with Bokeem Woodbine, but since she made her debut in Mobetta Blues, that was our first time getting an experience with the record jazz thing that Guru and I did for that soundtrack. And it was our first time meeting Branford Marcellus, who became actually, we lived together briefly because I've said it before in another episode, he became the music director for The Tonight Show when Johnny Carson stepped down and Jay Leno took over. So he was in the process of moving to LA. We were looking, Guru and I were looking for a place to live in Brooklyn because we were living in the Bronx at the time. So when we moved from 183rd in the Bronx, shout to the third, we ended up living with Branford, his son Reese, and his former wife Tetch. Shout to all of them. We're still all family and we're still friends to this very day. But through that process, that led to our recognition of getting to a major label after that record was put out, which was also directed by Spike Lee, which was a great thing. He didn't direct Caught Up, but still just the experience of being with Spike, and he shot the video for Jazz Thing. We had to do an episode on that one day. But in the meantime and in between time, let's continue forward. Now, this is the dope thing about this song. Sometimes when you make a record for a soundtrack, it has to be precise to what they're looking for, especially when you're putting music together for a film. It was accepted on the spot. Once we saw what the subject matter was, Guru and I are very good at pinning and creating a song that matches the particular soundtrack, and work just happened to pop off. We liked it so much that when we were finishing our album, we asked, do we have the rights to take that song and put it on our album after a specific time? Because in some contracts, you're given a certain specific time that they can own the rights to it before you can take it somewhere else and do something else with it. They said, no, since we're label mates with the soundtrack and you're putting out your next album, go ahead and just put it on the album now.
Nice.
It was like, bet. Now, making this record is very important to stick, no pun intended, stick to the script. Every soundtrack that we've ever recorded for, we usually get a sneak peek at the film, even if it's still basic, so that we can know how to format our approach to it. And when we saw it, the first thing I said is, well, for, and they even said, can it be a little more up-tempo and the typical gangstar sound with a little bit of brightness to the vibe of the music.
Sounds about right.
First thing I thought about was pianos, and the horn stabs just happened to come before the pianos, but when I heard the piano sound that I was looking for, as simple as it is, it definitely made for the perfect record to fit that soundtrack, and mainly for the film. And after that, the thumbs were up. Another thing that happened because of this song right here was in 2021 during the pandemic, we were invited to be in a commercial to advertise for Queens clothing company, Amy Leon Dory. They're well known out here in New York and worldwide. And with that, they said, let's recreate this song with your band, The Batter Band. Shout to The Batter Band, all the members, you know who you are. We put together, and this is during COVID testing, lots of tests and everything, just to even make it go smooth.
Right.
And we did it, everybody passed their test, and we did a dope commercial, which actually, take a look at the commercial.
I think I remember, let's see. Yeah, I think I remember this commercial.
Here we go.
Yep, I remember this commercial, yep. Yep. We'll be right back.
in work. I put in work. I put in work and watch my status escalate.
Nice.
I'm proud of that. Guru is definitely smiling on all the things that are continuing to carry on the legacy of Gangstar. And we appreciate everybody that still continues to support our brand. Shout to his son, KC, Keith Elam. And shout to the entire family, the Elam family, the Clark family, Big Shug, the co-founder of Gangstar, and everybody from the foundation and every fan that still loves everything that we continue to do. So, the next thing you know, let's put this into the S950. And when you insert it and load it up and connect it to the MPC-60 to trigger the sounds that are contained on this disc, and it goes like this.
Mm-hmm. Are you working? What kind of work do you do? What is it you want to do when you grow up?
Hey, yo, I'm going to be a tit-out. That's all my eyes can see. Victory is mine. Yeah, surprisingly, I've been laying, waiting for your next mistake. I put in work and watch my status escalate. Now I'ma start collecting props, connecting plots, networking like a conference. Cause the nonsense is yet to stop. Jake, shake me down. Haters wanna take me down, break me down, clap. All they heard was a sound. Yo, I scoped it out. I took your weak dream and choked it out. Your bitch don't really got no ass. She just poked it out.
You know, anytime I do gigs, even when Guru was still here and we were doing Gangstar gigs, it is one of the biggest records that jumps off every time whenever we let it go. And to this very day, when I do DJ gigs, when I let that record go, it gets the crowd real hyped. So we're very proud of this one. And
I peeked that he got his little custom record, his custom coded records with his head on it. That was dope right there. I saw that in the little million commercial was, I thought it was something he just happened to have, but I like that's his thing now. That's awesome.
So it garnered a gold album. Our first gold album, actually.
Yeah, that's crazy.
So
that's ever
to be
first
able
gold
to
album.
Say that this was a part of it, and we thank you, Work, for being accepted by not only clothing brands but also by movie soundtracks, and we like that type of stuff. And you know, salute, floppy disk. That's what's up.
Heard up, baby. Shit is mad shady, but I got to get the gravy.
Cool. Another good episode of So What's Up? Salute to Floppy Disk. Alright, next one, like I say, I'm skip. Next one would have been So What's the song? The title of the album, So What's Up? I already did it and everything. So we're gonna go jump ahead and we're gonna jump ahead to right remember. I'm gonna start spilling now that we're getting close in there. And we're jumping ahead to Crumb Snatchers getting closer to God. So this is gonna be another one. I'm definitely gonna have to hear someone explain this story real good, because I'm not too familiar with it by name. But probably when I hear it, I'm like, oh, that's that song. But anyway, other than that, if you like my reaction, like, share, subscribe my YouTube channel. Shout out to DJ Premier, one of the greatest producers of all time. And always, rest in peace, Guru. It's your boy T-Bear signing off. One love.